Hey guys, and welcome to today's episode of Skandy Tutorials. Today, we're going to learn how to change the colour of anything inside of an image, from clothing, lips, background, footwear, and to do that, we're going to be using colour range. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial as much as I enjoyed making it for you. Okay, so you ready for today's tutorial? Now, the first thing to do, as always, is drag and drop the image that you're going to use into Adobe Photoshop. Now, I'm going to use this image here, which is saved as a .png, which means that the background is transparent. Now, if you're not sure on how to make a background transparent, or I'm assuming that your image has already got a background, you want to try and have a selection that looks something like this by using the quick selection tool. And if you're not sure on how to use that, then check it out over here in the top right. Pow! And that'll show you how to remove a background really easily. So I'm just going to add a background in so we can see a really easy transition between the background and the foreground image. So add a layer in the bottom right, like so, and then I'm going to have my paint bucket tool selected, and I'm going to roughly use this green as my background, and I'm just going to left click and fill, like so. Then I'll just drag that to the bottom so I've got a selection that looks like this. Now the next thing to do is select the top layer and create a layer on top. So now you've got three layers, layer two, and obviously you've got your background. Now the next thing to do is go over to select and click color range, and then you want to kind of define the whites from the blacks. So the blacks will deselect and the whites will select. So if I pressed OK now and then I change the coloring, what's going to happen is everything that's black will stay the same and everything that is white will change color. So we want to use this area, or this the color range menu, to kind of define to Photoshop which area that we're going to change the color of. So the first thing, you can get a good selection by using skin tones. It will start as sample colors, so don't worry if it looks something like that. You can get a kind of good selection from skin tones, if I can remember the name of it. But for this, I want to change the color of the gown or nightdress or nighty, or I don't know what you call it all around the world, but whatever it is, dress, we'll call it a dress, even though it's not, never mind. So we want to make this white and the rest of the body black, and then the background black as well, so we don't change anything other than the gown, dress, nighty, I don't know. So anyway, I'm not going to use skin tones, I'm going to use sampled colors. Then with my eyedropper tool, I'm just going to make a selection of the front, like so. So now you can see that the rest of it is kind of blacked out, but it's just left all of this in white for me to be able to change the color. Now, there are a couple of little imperfections here. Don't worry about that. And if it's not caught all of your kind of area, then just use the plus eyedropper and then just add in extra colors like that. So I'd say I was pretty much happy with that. Now also change the fuzziness up and down because it'll help you with your selection, and you want to try and make it until you've got a clear contrast between black and white, so something that looks like that. And we're going to use masking to get rid of these parts here, so I wouldn't worry about that too much. Now press OK. So as you can see, it's made a selection of all around these areas, down and all down here, and so on and so forth, with a couple of little places missing, but don't worry about that too much. Now click on your adjustment layers in the bottom panel and then select hue and saturation, check colorize. So now you can see that this has just slightly started to change color. Now adjust your hue, saturation and lightness depending on the color that you want to use. So I could go up here and increase the saturation, kind of make it like a purpley color, increase the lightness of it a little bit, or the darkness. Now the more vibrant the color, you will be able to change to more vibrant colors. So say for example we're doing lipstick and we've got red lipstick on, you'll be able to change vibrant red lipstick to vibrant blue lipstick, but it's kind of got to be in the same, I don't know, kind of the same brightness of color, if you see what I mean. But you can still get a really good selection of all different colors, but you've just got to mess around with the saturation and also the lightness as well to kind of get it perfect, to, you know, make it look real. So I'm just going to go to, I don't know, say try and get a pinkish color, increase the saturation and the lightness as well. And I'd say, yeah, might as well keep it like that. Move this across a little bit actually. And then we'll keep it like that, like so. But what it's done is it's made a couple of, you know, changes. It's made this part kind of purple as well, which, you know, it can look pretty good because, you know, it's only changing based on what colors are the same. So this area here was obviously the same color as this before, which is why it's changed it to this color. So it can be, you know, a really cool way of adding effects if you wanted to, or enhancing lightnesses on the face like this, for example. But just for my example, I'm going to show you masking of how to, you know, how to get rid of it. So have a look in your mask. So I've got the whites here, so I want to select blacks because I only want this area to be highlighted white. Press B on the keyboard to select the brush tool and use the brackets under the plus and return key to change the size, and then just kind of get rid of any areas that you don't want to include and just go around it really quickly like so, and you'll see a change here. So you kind of get a, you know, a rough idea of where you are and what you're editing. So I've pretty much blacked all of that out, and now I'm just left with this white selection here, starting to look pretty good. Now if you want to change the background, all you need to do is just do the complete opposite of what you just did. So you'd want to make this part black and then make the background white. So create a new layer on top, go to select and then select color range, and then I'm just going to turn my fuzziness up just to start with, and then I want to kind of make a selection of the outside and a deselection of anything on the inside. But I might be able to just catch it with fuzziness actually. Yep, I don't need to make any other selections on the inside. Pretty happy with that. And then just press OK. So now we've got a selection of all around the outside which perfectly matches the edges of every single color. So that's a kind of perfect outline. And then go over to your adjustment layers again and select hue and saturation. Check colorize, and then you can mess around with the colors of the background. As you can see, we can kind of bring it up here and we can bring it to a, you know, a similar purple if we wanted to, make it lighter, change it over. It's entirely up to you which color you want to use. I think I'm just going to make this one a little bit kind of girly if you like. So I'll change that to kind of that pink to match the lips a little bit, but I'm going to increase the colors of the lips as well, and I'll show you how to do it. So I'd say, yep, pretty happy with that. Leave it as it is. So just cross it away. Now the next thing to do, same again, new layer on top, select, and then color range. Now this time we want to just kind of make the lips white and make everything else around the outside black. So I'm just going to turn this up again and then make a selection of the lips and then turn the fuzziness down and then press OK. So that's a little bit better this time. Now click the hue and the saturation on the adjustment layers again, and then you can make your changes to the lip colors like so. So if I wanted to kind of bring this to the same color, then I'd just increase it and change the lightness and the darkness as well. The more time that you spend on it, obviously the better selection that you're going to get. But if you do want to kind of really zoom in and mess around, then, you know, feel free to do so. I'm just going to have this on black and then just get rid of these parts. So it is just the lips that are selected. Turn the flow up and the hardness as well. Then you can kind of build in. I mean, if you do miss any little parts, obviously, it's, you know, it's never going to be perfect. There is always going to be a degree of, you know, messing around. So just feel free just to kind of mess around with it. If you want to build in or build out, then just, you can actually sample the colors. Like, say, for example, if I just create a new layer on top, I select this color here like so, and then I turn my flow right down. and turn the hardness down. And then select a smaller brush. By just selecting the colours from everywhere, you can actually build in smaller parts just to make it look a little bit more natural. Now obviously it is, you know, quite pixelated as we go closer, so when you zoom out you know you're really not gonna see it, but just messing around with it is, you know, it helps to kind of create and make it, you know, perfect the way that you want to use it, or the way that you want it to look, should I say. So just sample colors from, you know, all over, and you could just literally build it in yourself if you needed to. And then when you scroll out and look at the picture at its kind of normal resolution, you turn that off, you can see that, you know, we've made a complete change to the lip color, and then adding the color in on top. And obviously once that's on, you know, you can't tell the difference, and we've literally changed everything, the color of our dress, gown, nighty, whatever it is. The background color we've changed a couple of times, and that's how you do it in Adobe Photoshop. But anyway, I hope you like this tutorial, guys. Please like, share, don't be a pen tool, and subscribe to my channel.